Lower urinary tract obstruction, or LUTO as we many times refer to it, is a obstruction of the urethra, the tube that connects the bladder to the outside world.
It's really almost a minor anatomic abnormality, but the consequences of it are profound.
It is a very rare anomaly.
It only occurs in about 1 in 5 to 7,000 births.
They are usually felt to be sporadic conditions with no increased recurrence risk.
Obstructions to the urethra actually come in many different forms. There can be a flap of tissue in the urethra that is called posterior urethral valves and probably has to do with the development and completion of that simple tube that's the urethra. There can be a complete obstruction where the tube of the urethra just never connects, and that's a urethral atresia. And then there's a really kind of unusual subpopulation of fetuses that have just a very constricted narrowing in the mid portion of the urethra that just results in a very high restricted ability for the urine to pass.
The more significant the obstruction, and the earlier that occurs, the more profound the effects on the fetus.
It's important for the families to really understand the relationship between urine production and amniotic fluid.
Most of the fluid around the human fetus is fetal urine. The fetus pees into the amniotic space and then gets rid of this fluid by swallowing it, and it's absorbed and goes back to the mother. So there's a circulation going on.
We know that amniotic fluid is very important not only for the baby to move prenatally, but that then promotes lung development.
With lower urinary tract obstruction, one of the problems is the baby is unable to maintain sufficient amniotic fluid volume, and as it ingests and digests the amniotic fluid, the volume of amniotic fluid drops. And at a certain point, the amount of amniotic fluid around the baby is so low that it can start to predispose to the complications of interfering with lung growth, and we refer to that very low amniotic fluid level as oligohydramnios.
And if the oligohydramnios is there for many, many weeks, the lungs are extremely small.
And they never develop those small branching airways. They never develop the necessary number of air sacs to survive.
So the absence of amniotic fluid will result in pulmonary hypoplasia or underdeveloped lungs, which is actually the cause of death in complete lower urinary tract obstruction.
When you have LUTO, it's causing the obstruction, and obstruction leads to increased pressure.
Because the pressures get so high in the bladder as it's trying to empty itself, the urine that's produced in the kidney can't be pumped down through the ureters into the bladder.
Back pressure put upon the kidneys can irreversibly affect them.
The kidneys are basically the world's most productive recycling system, where all the proteins and electrolytes that our bodies want to reabsorb get reabsorbed, and all the waste products get excreted.
So if you have obstruction at a critical time point with the kidneys developing, that leads to what we would say renal damage.
Renal damage from long-standing obstruction means that the kidneys are not able to perform that recycling function and are essentially excreting all of the electrolytes and proteins into the urine.
These are conditions that, you know, a fetus is born with or is developing with. And, you know, our goal is to try to make as normal as possible what, for some reason, wasn't developing normally.